Last year, my friend Gina Alpey died. She died because, oh boy, thank you for the ahs back there. I appreciate it.
We'll preserve our decorum in the chamber. Proceed, lady.
She died because the Medicaid cut kept her from having absolutely essential medical equipment that she needed and could not afford. That's not the only story like that that we could cite here. The Medicaid cuts have created pain and misery and real death throughout our state. And rather than having a serious discussion about how to restore health care for our friends and neighbors, our brothers and sisters, children of God, we are playing a trick, borrowing part of the language from a bill that I've worked on for years to create a tax bill that would be fair and adequate and would give a cut to the 60% of Missourians who have those households that have less than $47,000 of income. A bill that was carefully crafted to only ask the richest 20% to come up with what we were asking the bottom 80% in Missouri to come up with, so that we would have fairness. And so that we could restore some of the $1 billion of core spending that's been cut over the past decade in Missouri. Money that's needed by our veterans, money that's needed by our schools, money that's needed in the healthcare system, money that's needed so that low-wage workers can afford to have child care for their kids. We have to figure out how to have adequate revenue for our state's needs to provide a high quality of life for our citizens. But instead of looking seriously at that issue, just as in the hearing on my bill that the gentleman from St. Louis County cited, we didn't have a serious discussion of my bill that night either. Mr. Speaker, you were there. You know that basically that was a big spin fest where we just talked about my bill as a $1 billion tax increase, which is not an accurate labeling of it. It's a tax cut for 60% of Missouri workers. This bill does not have that same refundable income tax credit in it that would help those workers. And instead of having the regard and the respect for our hurting neighbors who have had Medicaid cuts take away essential equipment from them, essential services from them, so that some that were making progress toward walking are now not having that possibility, and so that some have had premiums be so unaffordable that they cannot insure their children any longer. Instead of having a serious discussion, we're playing a game like this, Mr. Speaker. I think that's a real shame.
Ladies, time has expired.